Hi there, and welcome to my latest model train review video to come of October 2019. And the model train I'm going to be reviewing today is the newer Hornby Eurostar, which is in the newer livery. This one is split from the train set, and it has been pre-fitted with a DCC decoder already to go. So I can use the Hornby Select for this, although this one is split from the train set that came out in 2015, although I do believe Hornby are re-releasing this model later this year. But I will cover those in another video. And because this model is split from the train set, I will put the reference number into the description just to assist anyone that would be interested in buying one of these Hornby train packs, or one of these that's been split off from the train set. Although this may be hard to believe, this Hornby Eurostar is pre-owned, although it is in immaculate condition from what I've seen of it anyways, and have tested the motor unit, of which is in the top here, and the whole four-piece train pack is in polythene, as it would have been issued by Hornby back in 2015. And just to have a look at the power car, this one is the motor unit, numbered as 3219, and I will be covering this in some close-ups when we put it on the turntable. But just going over the components briefly first, and to avoid duplication, I just want to show off the fleet numbers first. And there is no instructions or anything included with this pack, although to be honest, I'm a fairly experienced railway user, model railway user anyways. And this one is numbered as 3220, so I believe this could have been an ex-regional set. The detail at the front is very nice, although sadly the only letdown with the Hornby Eurostar is that this one does not have working directional lights, although I'm sure there is lighting kits available if you wanted to retrofit a lighting kit yourselves. And here is the one of the articulated cars. I'll just show the end with the coupler, which is just a clip coupler to the articulated wheel set in the middle, and the non-articulated motor end on this part of the Eurostar as well. I do plan to get some of the extension coaches, and it would be grand if Hornby would consider making the articulated carriages for the Eurostar. As to be honest, apart from the HST, the Hornby Eurostar is another one of my favourite passenger trains from Hornby to come as well. So just to show you what's in the box, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to pause the video, and then I will do some close-ups of the motor unit and this part of the train, as these two are identical and I don't really want to repeat myself too much by just going over the same thing with these. So, back in a moment. Now I've unboxed the Class 373 Eurostar from Hornby in the new Eurostar livery. As you can see, it is a very nice model in my opinion. I do like the livery, although to be honest, there hasn't really been much change in terms of the tolling from when the original Eurostar came out by Hornby in 1996. So what I'm going to do, just for some close-ups, and starting with the front end, We do have the Eurostar and the Eurostar logo on the front, just above the horn grille that's in between the headlights. Although sadly this model does not have any working headlights. Although I do believe there are lighting kits available if you wish to retrofit directional lighting into your own model yourselves. And I may do this with this one later on, along with the other version I do plan to get as well. This one is numbered, as previously mentioned, as 3219. The detail's quite good on the well sets or bogies, whichever you prefer to call them. Although most of it, in fact all of the detail, is moulded and is not separately fitted. The handrails to the driver's cab door are also moulded as well, and the cab window is painted rather than separately fitted. And if we just pan alongside the model here, and if we just zoom in, here is the international fleet number of this power car. Just waiting for my camera to focus on this. And you do have the grills as well. And the panels are picked out nicely. Although, as I said before, the majority of this detailing is moulded rather than separately etched, as technically this model is 23 years old in terms of the tooling anyways. Although this version of the model was released in 2015 and has been upgraded to being DCC ready, and it does have a DCC decoder pre-installed, as this is how I purchased the train pack as is. And what I'm going to do, just going to turn the model slightly around and then zoom back in just to reset the autofocus. There is some ventilation grills on the roof as well. I believe these grills are for the dynamic brake or the electric brake motors, as they use large cooling fans to keep the traction motors cool whilst under electronic braking, due to the amount of energy given off when the brakes are in force. And here is some more grills and the electrical equipment above. And I have raised the DC pantograph just to show the pantographs that they are adjustable. And the rear one is an AC one, and this one can be raised and lowered as well. And I will demonstrate the AC pantographs when we do the test run, which will be coming up after the close-up of the first passenger car. So, what I'm going to do, just pan the camera down, just zooming in on the rear details, which is okay, and it is very acceptable by today's standards. This model doesn't look dated at all, although I hope Hornby do add directional lighting to their Eurostar model, as I think it would benefit this model, to be honest, and it would bring it right up to date with their other model trains, especially the Class 395 Javelin train, which does have directional headlights. So, without further ado, let's commence with a 360 degree rotation then, shall we? Just going to zoom out a wee bit more, just so we don't clip the model whilst we turn it around on the turntable, as this model train is quite long and I don't want to cut it out on the view of the camera, at least if I can possibly avoid it anyways. And as we come to the back of the model, Here's a close-up of the pantographs and the rear corridor, plus the basic hook coupler, which is still good for its use, and it is quite stable even when the train is going in reverse compared to some of the tension lock couplers, which can buckle under each other and cause a derailment. Just continuing on with the rotation of this model, I'm just going to zoom in again just so the model doesn't go too far away from the camera. And what a fantastic model this is. If you do like the Eurostars, I would certainly recommend getting one of these Hornby models, as for the prices they sell for, they are pretty good value for money. Although, as I've previously mentioned, the only detraction from this great model from Hornby is that there is no directional head and tail lights, which is the only letdown for this otherwise excellent model. As we come round to the front, just look at how modern that cab view is. And this is why I do like the Hornby Eurostar and the real Class 373 Eurostars, because of its very modern streamlined design. And this livery does look very nice on this model as well. And I prefer this livery to the older livery, to be honest. But that's just my opinion. And what I'm going to do now, just going to pan the model around, and then move on to a rotation of the first passenger coach. Although I will place this one onto the test track for when we move on to the test run. And now we move on to the close-up of the passenger car, of which this one is the first of the two, as I've used the articulated version just to show more of what this car entails. There is a passenger interior on this model, and this is one of the otherwise motor coaches. However, there is no motor on this one, as there is just a Wee motor in the power car that we've just previously covered, and we shall do some close-ups of this. The grills are semi-etched and they are molded into the model tooling itself, and most of the detail on the trucks or bogies is molded as well. And here is the loop coupler that goes into the coupling hook on the rear of the power car, and the detail is very good. Although this model tooling is approximately 23 years old, just to point that out, this model doesn't look out of date or anything, and it still fits in well with the newer model trains. Although I think an upgrade, perhaps with directional lighting for the power cars, perhaps a cab interior, and maybe some interior lights for the carriages would make this model complete, and perhaps detail the pantographs a bit more, and that would make this model up to date with the rest of the premium models, or at least it would in my opinion. But anyways, just going to zoom in on this detail here. Excuse me. We have the destination board to the left of the saloon door, and the passenger door is picked out in grey just to meet the Disability Discrimination Act, as that brings the model up to date. And you have the Eurostar logo there as well. Just zooming out again. There is an air conditioned grille underneath on the bottom of the carriage, although I believe it is air conditioning. And the detail is very much covered here. So what I'm going to do, just going to zoom right out, as this carriage is slightly longer than the power car due to the articulated bogey or wheel set, whichever you prefer to call it, of which we're just coming round to now. Just panning the camera slightly to keep it all in focus. And just looking at the detail this end, I believe these are brake cylinders. And I believe there is this slight indentation just here, would be where a passenger door illumination light would be. Although please correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that's what that represents, although it is not represented on this model. And it is non-functional on the model, although I believe it is an orange light on the real Eurostars, from what I've seen on the YouTube videos anyways. So what I'm going to do, just going to continue panning the camera around, just to show off the detail this end. And basically what this does, you just couple the other carriage into this socket in the middle, and that is then ready to go. And it is a clever way of Hornby allowing you to couple the two carriages together without having one of these crude looking hooks on the bottom. As you may remember seeing those on my Lemur TGV reviews that I've done in the past. But anyways, staying on topic, just going to continue on with the rotation. And I'm going to zoom out a wee bit more, just so we don't clip the carriage out of the view. I really, really do like this livery. And to be honest, it does bring the Class 373 Eurostar in line with most modern liveries. And I will be getting the extension carriage pack to go with this train, as well as the full train set and the train pack, which may have different fleet numbers, and I will be doing revised reviews of those as well. So just bringing the carriage round, and that will conclude our close-ups. Right then, the next thing to do is to commence with a test run of this Hornby Eurostar in the new Eurostar livery. And this is a very nice model from Hornby. I'm using the Hornby Select, and the address I've set the decoder to is 19, as it matches the fleet number. So let's just turn this on to 10% and 20%. And if my memory serves me correctly, the speed and the acceleration of this model is quite fast as well. So I don't want to turn it up too high. And the train used in the background is 6062 on the tankers again. And I've just left that one in just for the background train, as the main focus is on the performance of this Hornby Eurostar. So let's just increase the power a wee bit more, and let's take it up to 40% power. Bearing in mind this is a very new addition to me, so I'm going to give it the running session of 30 to 45 minutes in each direction, just to allow the driveline and the gearing to bed in, as that will improve performance. Although, looking at this video, the Eurostar appears to be a very smooth runner, and this is on DCC and not DC. And as you may have noticed, I have raised the 25,000 volt AC pantographs, just like I said I would in the close-ups, as the front pantographs are for the 3000 volt DC lines in Europe, which are used in France and Belgium, as where the rear pantographs towards the back of the locomotives, as these ones are raised, are used on the high speed lines and the local AC lines that use the 25,000 volt catenary system. Just increasing this to exactly 40% power. As you may notice, the acceleration is very good. And I have just used the decoder's default settings, as apart from changing the address from 3219 to just 19, as I'm using a Hornby select, I haven't changed any of the other settings on the Hornby Eurostar. But I'm sure that most of you may agree with me that if this model had lights, it would improve the model considerably more. And I'm sure that Hornby could implement this into the existing tooling without too many alterations, as Hornby has upgraded the power car to have DCC in provision, of which you can just simply plug a decoder into it and away you go, as this model already has DCC already fitted. And I may need to get another decoder for the rear pantograph, correction, the rear power car. We'll get there in the end, power car. So that I can control the directional lights on the rear power car. There we go, got there in the end. Kind of got tongue-tied around the pantograph, but never mind. But apart from some painted detailing on the pantographs and the upgrade with directional lights, this model is still very good for its age. And I certainly will be getting the extension cars to make this train longer, and I do hope that Hornby will consider making the articulated extension cars, as I think that's all that's really needed to complete the Eurostar train, in my opinion. But anyways, what I'm going to do, I'm going to allow a couple more passes, and then I will just show the train going past from another angle, and then it'll soon be time to wrap up this review. So I think one more pass and then we'll be grand. I'm sure most of you will agree with me that the Class 60 and the Eurostar does make for a very nice contrast, with the Class 60 being in red and the Eurostar being in mostly blue. Or at least they appear to contrast well in my opinion. I thought it'd be a good idea to place the camera here just to cover the test run from another view, as that keeps the video more interesting in my opinion. Unfortunately, I've not been able to use the generic signal on the background train as I've lost my 9 volt battery. So I will have to get a new one, although as I control this model railway, the tanker train has full permission to pass the signal regardless. So just want to point that out, as in case some of you may wonder why the colour light signal is not operational, and the reason being is that I've lost the battery. So I will be getting another one probably tomorrow when I'm next down the sharp, and I may go for a more powerful one just to make the light more brighter. Because to be truthful, those cheap 9 volt batteries, although the signal was working, the brightness does not last as long as it does with the more expensive, better quality 9 volt batteries. Once I get some resistors and stuff, I will probably connect it up to the controller, as then I won't need a battery, and the second plus is that with extra resistors added, it will stay constantly bright without burning out the LEDs. But anyways, I'm gonna allow a couple more passes and then it'll be time to wrap up this review of this Hornby Eurostar, which is a great model in my opinion, apart from the obvious flaws that I have mentioned during the review and the close-ups. I hope you have enjoyed watching this review of the Hornby 2015 issued model of the Class 373 Eurostar. This version is the train pack that was part of the train set, that has obviously been split from the train set that has recently joined my fleet. Factoring the lack of directional lighting and perhaps some extra picked out detail, which would have made this model look fabulous, I'm going to round this one off with an 8 out of 10, as if the Eurostars had directional headlights and tail lights, that would bring this model up to date with the rest of the train parks of the modern image high-speed trains, as despite the lack of directional lights, which I'm hoping Hornby will look at this in the future and perhaps upgrade the model to have directional lights in the future on other alternative models of the Class 373 Eurostar. It is a great model for its age, as the Hornby Eurostar first made its appearance in 1996 in the original Eurostar off-white livery with the yellow wraps around the cab. But I think an 8 out of 10 is a fair and justified score for this Hornby model, as it does run really well. Most of the noise is coming from the wheels, as I can barely hear the motor. The motor is not loud compared to some of the other model trains from Lemur that I have. And the performance of this Eurostar pack is very smooth, and that is straight from the box. And I can only imagine that the performance will be even better once the model has been run in a few times. But anyways, I think an 8 out of 10 for this Hornby Eurostar pack is a fair and a justified score. And that concludes my review. As always, thank you for watching. I appreciate all positive and constructive feedback on my content that I create. But until next time, have a good week or weekend. Take care, all the best, and God bless. I will see you all in another video. See you later.